Coney Glen Road is a short scenic suburban pass located on East Head at the Knysna Heads. The road is narrow and attracts tourist traffic as well as local traffic. The 12 bends are almost all sharp, so a speed of lower than 40 kilometers per hour is appropriate. There's a well-managed view site about halfway up the pass, but you need to park and walk some 50 meters or so to access the view site, which offers sweeping views of the heads and the lagoon. Once the southern descent commences, the road is brick-paved and also quite steep. The many speed bumps and water channels ensure a low speed is maintained. The road is a cul-de-sac, so can only be approached from the north. The best time to drive this little pass is between noon and 1400 hours, when the light will not be in your eyes and your photos and videos will look good as well. Tourism is Knysna's main source of revenue, and there's plenty to see and do in and around the town. Besides the modern shops in the town centre, there are also churches and museums aplenty, and of course a boat trip on the John Bend to explore the Featherbed Nature Reserve is a must, but be aware that it does take some time and you'll need to book in advance. For nature lovers, you can take a drive up to the Deepfalle Forest Station and do one of these several forest hikes of varying lengths and degrees of difficulty to suit the individual. If you prefer cycling, you can rent a cycle, and for the fitter, try the loop up to the Simola Golf Estate, Khona Pass and Komsapat for a magnificent circular route of approximately 4 hours duration. There's also sandboarding, paragliding, fishing charters, scooter forest tours, whale watching, lagoon and oyster tours, or catch the lagoon sunset cruise. Stefanus de Blance was the first white settler in the Knysna area. He farmed at Melkhout Kraal, which was established in 1770. De Blance died in 1790 after having had the loan rights for over 20 years. His widow, Hester Marx, stayed on the farm and ran it with the help of her children. She subsequently remarried Johann Lindenbaum in 1798. George Rex, who had a profound impact on the establishment of Knysna, left the British Admiralty Court in the Cape, where he had practiced as a lawyer, after the handover of the Cape to the Batavian Republic, and in 1804 bought the loan farm Melkhout Kraal from the deceased estate of Richard Holliday, who had a year earlier purchased it from Lindenbaum. George Rex, extending his landholding, bought the farm eastward between Grey Street and Salt River and later ceded 80 acres to the colonial government, on which the Royal Navy laid out the naval township of Melville on the lower part of the town in 1825, named after Viscount Melville, the first Lord of the Admiralty. On the death of George Rex in 1839, his properties were put up for sale. Lieutenant Colonel John Sutherland of the Indian Army bought the northern section of Melkhout Kraal during a visit to the Cape in 1844. The village of New Haven was surveyed by William Hopley and laid down in 1849. The Irvine were then offered for sale by John Sutherland, the Colonel's son. Knysna was at this time a field cornetcy of Plettenberg Bay in the division of George. It was declared a separate magisterial division in 1858, bounded in the west by the Swart River, the east by the boundaries of the division of Humansdorp, and north by the Otaniquas, and south by the Indian Ocean. In 1882, the two villages plus the wedge, a triangle of land between the two villages, being the remaining land of the farm eastward, were amalgamated to form a municipality known as the Knysna, taking its name from the Knysna River. Knysna is a Khoi word meaning fern.